Hello, my name is Robyn Marie Lamp, and I'm a soprano based in South Florida. I'm so excited to be here at the Norton Museum of Art singing with Opera Fusion, a boutique opera company in South Florida. We're here in the European Art Galleries, and I will be singing a few pieces inspired by the incredible artwork around us. I was immediately drawn to the magnificent tree in the foreground of this oil painting. It occupies such a prominent spot on the river and must offer the most glorious shade during hot summer days. This song by Gustav Mahler makes an association between the fragrance of an exquisite linden tree and the poet's beloved one. Fragrance memory is a real thing and has been proven to bring back powerful emotions in us. Mahler's genius setting depicts the wafting of the fragrance in the continuous and even motion of the accompaniment. This is Ich atmet einen linden Duft by Gustav Mahler.
Ich atmet einen
I knew I had to include this realistic painting in my concert because it is so different from everything else around it. The artist masterfully deceives the eye, making it appear as if the dead creatures are in 3D. I racked my brain trying to figure out a song that fits with this piece, but incredibly, I don't know any songs about dead chickens, dead insects, dead hens, anything like that. But I was speaking with Birgit Fioravante, executive director of Opera Fusion, and she reminded me that Giacomo Puccini, the famous Verismo opera composer, was an avid hunter and an excellent cook. He himself claimed to be, quote, a great hunter of wild birds, opera librettos, and beautiful women. There was only one family recipe for coot, which is a waterfowl, that he refused to disclose to anybody. But after his death, the secret recipe was discovered in a personal letter to a friend. So here it is. Let's all learn how to cook coot. You carefully remove the skin and marinate in water and vinegar for 1 hour. Rinse the meat and cut in quarters. Warm a pot on the stove and cook the meat with a bit of oil, carrots, plenty of onion, basil, marjoram, bay leaf, salt, and bell pepper. Cover and cook on low for 1 hour. Then remove the lid and sear the meat until brown. Add a cup of water with some wine and cook until absorbed. Then add chicken broth and cover the pot again. Cook on low for 30 minutes. At the end of that 30 minutes, you add flour to the pot to thicken the sauce. You serve the coot alongside crostini with the thick sauce spread on top. So there you have it, coot a la Puccini. So in honor of Puccini and his many passions, I'll sing an aria from his beloved opera, La Bohème. This is Si mi chiamano Mimì.
Soprano
When I saw this painting of travelers gathering around the river, this is what it brought to mind. Picture it. It's Brooklyn, summer of 1864. The Civil War is raging. Confederate sympathizers have ransacked the homes of abolitionists and freed slaves, as well as burned down two churches and an orphanage the year before. The city is anxious and afraid. It is brutally hot, as it's long before air conditioning and light clothing. The Reverend Robert Lowry of Hanson Baptist Church was physically and emotionally miserable and wanted to bring solace to his worried parishioners. To comfort them, in one day he wrote the tune and poem to this well-beloved hymn. "Shall We Gather at the River" tells of a shining crystal river which describes the water of life in both the physical and spiritual sense. In this oil painting, people are coming to the river to enjoy themselves. I can only imagine that Brooklyn congregation in 1864 longing for respite in a serene country scene like in this painting, beside a cool, lovely river. This setting of "Shall We Gather by the River" is by Aaron Copland, who was born in Brooklyn in 1900.
Shall we gather by the river, where bright angels' feet have trod, with its crystal tide forever flowing by the throne of God? Beautiful river, gather with the saints by the river that flows by the throne of God.
Heard of the story of Diana and Actaeon, so I asked one of the museum curators to tell me about it. Diana was a Roman goddess, and she was bathing in a spring when Actaeon, a great hunter, unwittingly happened upon her. She was startled and threw water on him, which turned him into a great stag. His own dogs then tear him to shreds. Another Roman story that ends in death is that of Dido and Aeneas. Dido, a great queen, falls in love with Aeneas, a great warrior who shipwrecks on her land. They want to marry, but Aeneas is tricked into leaving by an evil witch. Dido is heartbroken and builds a funeral pyre on which she burns herself. She chooses this manner of death so that as Aeneas sails away, he can see the flames and the smoke and know that she chose to kill herself. One of the most beloved arias in the operatic repertoire is Dido's Lament by Henry Purcell. Dido sings to her handmaidens right before she climbs the pyre. The descending chords you'll hear at the beginning of the piece make you feel as if you're watching Dido descend into her grave. This is Dido's Lament from Henry Purcell's Dido and Aeneas. I absolutely adore this panel of Madonna and her child by Italian painter Nozzadella. I love it because of the mischievous look on the toddler baby Jesus's face, and his mother is throwing up her hands as if she's had enough of his impish behavior and she's ready to put him to bed. So I thought a lullaby would be fitting. In this piece, Mariae Wiegenlied, or Mary's Lullaby, the accompaniment keeps a gentle rocking motion throughout, and it is easy to picture a tired Mary gently rocking baby Jesus to sleep.
Oh.
The Italian song O Sole Mio is one of my most favorites. It has been recorded many, many times, and it is extremely well known. The great tenor Luciano Pavarotti won a Grammy in 1980 for his recording. The great Russian cosmonaut Yuri Gagarin hummed this song as he was hurtling around the Earth for the first time, and it has even made appearances on Sesame Street, which, as we all know, means it's reached the epitome of popularity. This oil painting is called The Fisherman, but I was much more drawn to the sun's rays reflecting off the clouds in the background, which immediately brought this song's text to mind. The singer says that there is only one thing more beautiful than the sun after a storm, and that thing is the sun that shines from their loved one's face.